It's time to come back to Project Cars 2. Haven't played it for some time. Had some Assetto Corsa online races where I had to focus on training there. And I think it's time to finally move the career of Project Cars 2 forward. It's been a while. I finally finished the kart championships, all three of them, as I wanted to get all the accolades. So I am quite happy that has been completed. And yeah, I think it's time to move to open wheel. And the reason I'm going to do that is because I'm not the huge fan of open wheel myself, so I want to take care of it and be done with it. Actually, I thought I'll be moving to tier 5, which is a lie. I'll be staying in tier 6, Formula Rookie. Yeah, let's do it. So, we can choose between Asia, UK, and US. I think it will be best to do just to go as it is, Asia, then probably Euro Championship, and then I will go back to UK and US to get the accolades for those. I really want to have all of them. And the same as with as the Corsa, I want to get Platinum. I don't usually chase trophies on PlayStation. I think Project Cars 2 or Assetto will be one of them will be my first chase for a platinum. We'll see how it goes. So Asia goes first. Sportsland Sugo. Let's see what they have to offer here. Like those. Those are not too bad. I'll go this one. 39. Sheriff tier, or whatever it is. Yeah, sign the contract. Of course I am. Okay, let's see how it goes. I don't know this truck. To be completely honest, I think this is the first. Well, I drove on it a little bit, but not much. Okay. Would have to practice. We want on. Qualifying. We want on. 15 minutes race. The longest there is. I will always try to go at 100% length for all the races in the game. That includes Le Mans and whatever there is. I've already done the 24 hours of Le Mans in real time in Project Cars 1, so I don't see the reason not to do it in Project Cars 2. As time with the cards, we'll start at 100% and we'll use the practice session to adjust. It may be too hard, it may be too easy, we'll see. I will allow restarts because it can be funny sometimes at the start of the race and it's just a game. So let's treat it like a game. 100, 100 on, save. Okay, practice, have an hour to see if we need to set up the car and to learn the car truck combination. I did the kart at 100% difficulty, 100% aggression. It was quite doable. I know nothing about it done. I've got stable tuning set up to start with, and I think I'm going to stay with it. So let's just
Go, go,
go on track. That was unsafe release. That was another unsafe release. Oh, they cutting it hard here. Didn't expect to see that. Will I save it? Oh, let's just let them go. I don't have a heart on the main screen, but I have an application which allows me to display all the information on my second monitor. So my tires are super cold at the moment. My brakes are cold, my tires are cold. The only thing I don't know, what tires do I have? So I'm pretty sure they, by the setup, they, this is very unstable car. Let me see what tires I have. Slicks. Okay. Let's focus on warming up those tires. Oh, that's not good. Degrees in the front, 45 the coldest tire. Front brakes are keeping the temperature, and the green, the rear is super cold. 1:39 lap time. I have no idea how that compares to the AI. Left front, that's the warmer tire at the moment, it's still too cold. 50 rear right. Oh. At least the front brakes are keeping nice temperature, 400 degrees. Burning 0.82 liter per lap average. I made my load cell a bit harder for that car, but it's still locking the wheels. I may actually need to check the setup. I can reduce the strength of those brakes. The front left is finally green, 70 degrees, well it was for a second. So we may need to reduce the pressure in all of them, just to get them to the right temperature a bit quicker. Of course it may be that I'm too slow and I'm not able to keep the good temperature because of that. AI is definitely quicker than me in this terms. Slow down really for that. Whoa, they're really quick. Well, I'm really slow. Like I'm a bit faster in the quick turns, but I'm much slower in the slow turns. 36 is my best lap. really fighting with Skara. I don't feel it at the moment. And I lost it. Okay, so what are their times? 33. 33 versus my 36 and 12 out of 12, which is not a surprise. I was really slow. Return to pit box. Okay, before I start doing any changes, let's just load the loose setup and see how that works. That was horrible. I think I'm going to do... Well, first of all, I want to make sure those are the slicks. And I want to reduce the pressure. To rise the temperature. We'll see how that works. I'll do this almost the same enough. Now the brake pressure. Yeah, I'm going to reduce it a little bit. I want to keep the front balance. What else there is? Bearing ratio 12:0:1 seems to be good. My wheel's up to 1080. Yeah, I'm not touching that for now. Obviously, there is well too much fuel. There's 8 laps, right? So 9 liters, more than enough. Oh, I haven't checked the temperatures. But it's too short a race to break anything. The final gear. Oh, I cannot change it. Okay, I'll keep it like that for now. Let's just save it. And I think I have a setup for this. So I'm going to setup slot. I'm going to use this one. Yeah, let's do it that way. No other changes for now, and let's drive.
Hit confirm, we got that, Wilco.
Not a good start. Okay, is this a joke? That's better.
Go.
first feeling is this is a loose setup, but it feels much more stable. I don't understand that. I had a stable setup at first, and the car was sliding very crazy. I'm driving on a loose one. Or maybe I said it too early. It still feels more stable, for whatever the reason. The tires are still cold, so I cannot say this is because of the tire temperature. Yeah, even driving here feels like I feel more confident. And definitely here in these turns, I've got the same gear. This is crazy. Feels like I was still within the line. And even here, it feels so much more easier with this setup. It's called loose. The other one is called stable. The car is much more stable on this one. Maybe the loose stable means something different than stability of the car. It just doesn't make sense though. So yeah, the Formula Rookie, if you want to have an easier time driving that car, don't take the stable setup. It's not stable. Not at all. And even if I slide, it's so much easier to control it with this step up than the other one. It's actually a good test to see if I can escape the car. So it's already quicker than the other one. Still way too slow. And I don't have that much time to practice. This is only half an hour session and then qualifications. And to be honest, I don't want to spend too much time practicing it. Just too much the 100% AI. So I will probably reduce them. Either he went to pit stop. Yeah, I had to go to pit stop. I don't believe I drove so fast too. This setup I can go here on the last turn with full throttle, which it couldn't do previously because it was sliding. My left front is already keeping temperature 134, so I'm very close to fastest AI. Maybe not there yet. That was unnecessary reduction. I think I can match their speed in this turn now. With a slipstream, is he defending? They are way too slow here. I don't know why. Even driving behind him was a very low 35. I need to start finding a better braking points. Tires are still a bit cold, only the left front is now in green constantly. I have to go back to third because it's losing speed because it's uphill and the fourth gear is not able to pull the car or push, however you look at that. 133.8. So if that what that's what sorry that was like a long race, an endurance, let's see. But I'm not sure if we would consider a 1 hour race an endurance. That's still a sprint, right, in the world of the car racing. But even a 1 hour race, I would definitely spend more time setting the car because it's worth it, right? Because you will be racing there for an hour. But here's just 8 laps, so I won't be going above and beyond trying to set up this car to drive as fast as I can, because it's 8 laps and it's over. I think I'm pretty happy with where we are at the moment. I have to remember not to upshift here. Okay, so we've got, where are we? First with this time, by a small margin of 57 thousandths of a second. And this is for a default set with just a small changes to the to the tire pressure, which we're going to adjust a little bit. The left one stays where I want it to be, maybe a little bit lower. We need to disable symmetrical. Now this one needs to go even lower. And the rear, this one is the coldest, so this one has to go... Yeah, let's try that. And now we have this one, I'll keep it... Try to keep it at 90. Okay, let's see how this works for me. Save that. Okay, race, yeah. Actually race qual, I can put less fuel, but I think it matters that much. Good try. Didn't want to turn at all. That's why I stopped. It's a little cold. Have to lift the throttle a little bit. At least I did not uplift the gear to the throat. There we go, now I can do it. Coming to Project Cars 2 from Assetto Corsa. Requires... Well, it's last lap, doesn't matter. Coming after a kind of short break from Assetto Corsa to Project Cars require a bit of adjustment to the driving style. And I think I didn't have time to do it. Right. Books. I guess we should continue to qualifying. See how it goes. So we are still at 100% AI, 100% aggression. I'm actually going to reduce the fuel. Why not to? Nah, let's keep it. The reason I'm going to keep it because the tires is going to warm up. So I'm actually... I may need to have more laps available to me to set up a reasonable time. I'm not sure why I'm lighting up this system. Let's focus on the road, not on the dials. Dashboard is not important. Let's warm up this brakes. 160, 170, 200 in the front. The 50, 60. Almost 300, we've got 300, we've got green brakes at the front. Tires are still cold, so let's warm up the tires now. Tires are still cold, but they are warming up slowly. Such a slow and long ride uphill here. And then fourth gear, and we've got the time of 35. That's way too slow. That's really bad. That is really bad. How much time do I have? 10 minutes. Well, I'll try again. I don't want him to overtake me. In a flying lap, I should let him go, right? Right. Driving style between those cars and what I was driving GT3 and Assetto Corsa. But between those two games is so different. It's getting used to it, which takes a lot of time for me. That's why I never drive Project Cars before an online race in the Corsa and the other way around. Way too slow. Force feedback is getting hard at the turn. I will be slow as well, unfortunately. 33, 34, 35. Way too slow. I have a feeling that it was much better. The tires are still cold, and this is lap 3. Last out lap, so that's the 4th one. Front left finally warmed up. A bit risky, but I need that speed here. Thirty, 31. 33.7. Maybe I have time for one more. Maybe the lap I need for the pole position. We'll see. Unnecessary upshift. One minute 33.4. We'll see if that's enough for pole position. Three out of four tires were still cold. Only the front left was able to warm up enough. Could have been better. I put the pressure quite low for all four of them. But it will take like half a race to even get them to a reasonable temperature, not even talking about a good one.
Copy that, pit request confirmed. We're ready for you when you are.
How much time? There's 5 seconds left for the session, and I'm ninth with this time. Okay, it won't be an easy race. I may actually reduce this AI from 100% to something lower. Uh, 32.8 was their time. We'll try it. We'll see what happens. 9 out of 12, really bad. But I've got 8 laps to do something about it. Yeah, okay. Let's see. It may be or may not be fun.
First round of the championship. Just stay out of trouble and try and start off with a good
point. I truly am a rookie in this one. Not a bad start.
can't drive, man.
Okay, let's try again. I won't be lowering the difficulty for now. I'm going to keep it where it is. Jesus, man.
Come on, this guy's just in our way. Big push now, let's fight our way past.
If I can get a slipstream of this one, I should be able to pass this one, right? Ah, they're braking so much earlier than I do. It's surprising that they're so fast in qualifying, but they're so much slower in the race itself. I don't want to go too risky. he was pushing, Peter. Not cool, mate, not cool. Somewhere on the left. This time they're braking late. This is so crazy. They're unpredictable. AI is unpredictable. It really is. Maybe they're getting up to speed. Are we finding this? Yeah, the gap was big enough. If we can get a good slipstream. Riding behind this Q1. Yeah, maybe just enough. Let's see if we can pull now.
The fastest first section time.
Good. Higher temp is good, besides the rear right. Kinda got used to that. There was 132.9, that was my best lap with all three sessions, including qualifying. I would be close to pole position, it wouldn't be pole position though, I think they had 32.8 or something. Still, that just shows. That just shows how important the practice is. Just driving, driving and driving and getting faster just by driving. You don't need a super special setup. The setup is the last step. Once we've been driving long enough to get up to speed, once we proved our times, we've done hundreds of laps with a particular car on a particular track, and we are consistent, and we're not gaining any more time by doing more laps, and we know it's a time for a good setup to improve by another second or two. But as I said earlier, there's no point doing it for an 8-lap race.
Great final sector. Your left so far.
We're still within 33, so we're driving within our qualifying time. That was the first time I tried it on the third gear. That was the first time I tried to attack the curb. I didn't know it's possible in this car. I thought it would be risky and then I would spin. Another 33.05. I only have half a second advantage over the second. Another 33. A bit late on brakes. I was a bit risky. Sliding a lot there. Now this next braking zone is where I'm losing the most, I think. Yeah, definitely. So I'm pulling out here. This time I won't be upshifting, I have to remember about it. As soon as I hear that engine screaming for a upshift, I kind of do it automatically, but it's a mistake. Another 33, low, low 33.
You've done great so far, just keep pushing it all the way to the flag, you can take it.
Final lap. just want to keep it cool here. That was a ninth starting position. We're first. And I definitely want to keep it that way till the end. Yes, I enabled the cooldown lab because it's just cool, right? To do it like they do it in the real racing. I have manual pit stop, I have pit mistakes and all the stuff which make this game a bit more realistic, or which add to the realism and bring you a bit closer to what we can see in the TV or on a racetrack. And I'm really, really enjoying it. I don't care, they can go, I want it. Starting from 9. I'm curious if there is some kind of catch-up mechanism, because it wasn't too hard to overtake them, but then it was pretty much impossible to lose them, even though I was driving quicker than I was during the qualifying session. One would hope there isn't any kind of catch-up mechanism for AI. I would rather. It shouldn't be, because there's a difficulty, right? So why do you have a catch-up mechanism if you have a difficulty?
Congratulations, your first race win in the can. Lovely driving.
So, my fastest lap wasn't the fastest. 32.6. 32.3. 32.054. Ninth guy. That's so much faster than qualifications. It just doesn't make sense. But I guess this is what it is, right? Okay, so so my teammate was third. That's good, I guess. Pink. We've got 54 points. Oh, that's good. That's good. Nothing to complain about. Okay, what is the second round? Sakita Sprint. I know that track from Project Cars 1. But I think I will spend some time offline just to practice it a little bit. Car, and then I will jump to the official practice of that race. Ah, qualifying. Yeah, I was like, I won the race. What do you mean, not the best performance? Yeah, who cares? this again? Akita Sprint. Quick play, private testing. Just as information, I have this Mercedes chosen. I've been testing it because there will be an online race which I'm taking part of in that car on COTA GP version. So that will be very interesting. I haven't been working on the setup. I've been just driving a little bit. I think so far my best time was 2:23 or something like that. Not consistent. So there's more practice to be done. The race is on Monday. Plenty of time, I guess. Let's find that rookie formula. Class or group. So there's a classes. Okay. Where is it? Don't even know what it's called, that class. It's just called Rookie. Such a lovely car. Touring cars, what do they have here? Okay. Cool. Cannes. Didn't know there is a car like that here. There is a race involving that car as well coming soon. I think it's 7th of October. Haven't touched it. Don't know how it drives. We'll see. Might be interesting. Where is it? Where's the rookie formula? It appeared. What's it do? L2. Okay. No, that doesn't help, does it? Ah, here it is. It's called F5. Okay, if I knew earlier. It was Sakito. Which originally supposed to be Suzuka. Unfortunately, they didn't get the license in time in Project One, Project Cars One. So they changed it a little bit, called it Sakito, and that's what we have. And it looks like they transfer it to the Project Cars Two, and they have never added Suzuka, unfortunately. Have that instead. That was Sprint. 6 a.m. That's no, I'm still in bed at that time. 1 o'clock seems better. Let's give it a try. Rookie race. It's the same setup we used for our previous race. What I'm going to do, I'm going to enable a symmetrical setup. I'm going to keep tire pressure at 1 for all 4. This is going to be our starting point, right? Slick, 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 slick. I'm going to keep the brake pressure as it was in the previous race. It was good enough. I'm not going to change anything here. I don't know how much fuel it's going to consume on this truck, so we're going to keep it for the 10 liters level. Maybe we'll go a bit lower. And then I will adjust 8 liters. Cool. I'm going to save it. Takita Sprint, that's where I want to save it. So I'm going to call it the same, just under the new slot, under the new track, so I can use it in the future. Well, did it save it or not? Save? Yes, but it's in a different track, right? I thought it saves it for a track. Right. All tracks. Print. Oh, this is so annoying. You know what? I don't care. I'm going to save it under the same slot. So if I go now to tuning setup, I'm going to load setup. I'm going here. I've got Sugo. This is crazy. It doesn't save it. I would expect it to save it under the same name but under a different truck. For some reason, it's not doing that. It doesn't matter for that car. It's I'm just going to drive it in this championship and that's it. So I don't expect it to drive it in the future. Okay, let's give it a try. -29 degrees on all tires. It's not too warm.
Keep it real on the outlap. Won't have much traction until you get the tires warmed up.
We've got the whole truck for ourselves. Oh, the force feedback is working hard here. Bumpy truck. To expect. it's going. So far, it's the same as the GP truck. Are they giving extra points for this? Where am I driving here? Okay, here. Actually quite funny because I have unfinished championship at LMP2 I think it is World Endurance Championship in LMP2 class in Project Cars 1 on that same track, but of course in the longest possible version, the Grand Prix version. But that's on PC. I need to come back to it, but it's a 6-hour race, one of these endurances. So, yeah. For now, I'll focus on Project Cars 2 as the Corsa. But I will definitely go back to that Project Cars 1 game. I really love it as well. How fast I can drive here? It seems like I can be really fast here. So bumpy that first turn. The second part of it actually. That force feedback is really working hard there. Keep it in the truck. Keep it in the truck. Between the white lines, always. Ay-ya-ya, I'm too fast here. Okay, I think I'm getting a grip of this truck in this car. How fast I can... it's too fast. Well, but it's the only way to find out, right? Should I be driving here on the third or on the second wheel? Okay, that was much better. But right, left, right, it requires a bit of braking there. Just fine here. A second is overkill. Front left is the warmer one again. Again, the coldest one, 65 degrees at the moment, below the perfect working temperature. The last two was were 128. Of course, I don't know if they're good or bad, because I'm driving without AI for now. Okay, that was too fast again. I'm searching the limits. But if that would be a good lap, it would be 127. Okay, let's try to do a proper one. That was very dangerous. Okay, more or less I know the track and the car combination. A few more changes to the pressure of the tires. We're going to disable the symmetrical. One was staying the warmest. That. Coldest. Yep, I'm going to keep it like that. And that will be it for today.